Guess who's back? Back again. Shady's back. Tell a friend. Guess who's back? 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 Guess who's back?
All right. Good morning, my friends. I've been a bad YouTuber. Alright, yes, my friends, that is the current state of the build. I don't know how else to start this video by saying that. Good morning. Is that maybe how we should start? Yeah. If I look like hell and like I just woke up, it's probably because I have. And my makeup artist and my hairstylist, she quit. Yeah, she wasn't getting paid, so she quit. So I have no clue what I look like. I didn't go look in the mirror. I just woke up. First things first was coffee. Oh yeah, you know it. What do we got? This is a Peruvian blend, or Peruvian coffee from the Andes Mountains. Oh yeah, very smooth. Very similar to like a Folgers or Maxwell House, like an old style retro coffee. If you drank in coffees from the 1970s, 1980s, even maybe early 1990s, just a plain coffee, that's what it's like. Nothing fancy. And look at that, we're doing blah 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 already because I'm half asleep. And camera's pointing that direction, of course, Chuck. Why not? Be substandard this early in the morning. Anyways, we're already doing blah, blah, blah. So I have been a bad YouTuber. I haven't been filming much, and I haven't been building much. The past 4 days, I've barely been home. I've been out running around between work, and I made a couple purchases. We won't talk about the purchases today. We'll do a video on that, but they will be technically more part. Yeah, I was going to say part of this channel. You'll see a little bit of it because this is model building and cars, but it's another form of transportation that will be on my bike channel. So let's just say that. I'm smacking my lips already this morning. But some other things that happened is I've got the interior done, mock-ups done, ready to go. Engine's completed. Oh, I should probably take it off. Engine looked really good. I like it. I did a second paint coat on it. I did one paint coat long time ago. I wasn't happy with it because I had some overspray on it. So I repainted it and also repainted it because I put the oil filter on type of thing. So I'm happy with that. I'm going to put a decal on this, six-pack decal on the air cleaner, which will, does it match this? I can't remember if it matches that. But speaking of this, clearing, I've been waiting 2 weeks to clear this to get good weather. But you know what? My outside paint booth is a little bit wet and white. How the hell? Unbelievable. I can't believe this happened here. Usually this time spring is coming, the flowers are coming up, and yeah, surprise, never know in Canada, up in the northern climates, this can happen. And humidity for the past 2 weeks before we got this snow was like in the 90s, so I thought, you know what, we'll hold off to clear. I wanted this model kit done by the end of this coming week, which would be pretty close depending on this. Everything will be done except for probably the clear by the looks of it, because I got the next 5 days off, so I got time to concentrate on that. But let's get inside where it's warmer. Oh, the best way to get those chills out is, yeah, you know it. Feed the addiction, Chuck, feed the addiction. Oh, and I'm trying to be quiet because everybody else is sleeping in the house. So yeah, everything is about to go. Let's take the body off camera and show you the interior. Man, the lighting in here really, really sucks, like big time. So let's get rid of some of my tools out of the way. The only tool around here is me, no? Yes? That's what, whatever. I don't know where I'm gonna go with that, so we should stop there. Yeah, the hood turned out pretty fabulous. I like the gloss on it. Very surprised it turned out that good. So I'm gonna stick with the Rust-Oleum gloss. Heated and then laid out whenever we get to it. And then I will put the decals on because I'm not gonna clear over those decals. The decals might dry a semi-gloss, I'm wondering, I'm not sure. But I don't want them shiny as I did this one. So interior, got all the detailing, everything's ready to go. I really like how it turned out, pretty much. I wish the seats were maybe a little bit more wider. I should have put a couple coats on more and had some patience there. But you know what, that's okay. It's a learning lesson. Got to get back into back into airbrushing because as you've seen in previous video, the high cost of paints are just almost not feasible for me at this time to paint model kits at $20 a can. Like, holy crap, it's at the price, almost the price of a kit. So yeah, that's that blah blah blah, whatever. Tires, I took a file, and I know some guys take a drill and put tires in a drill and do that thing, but I just took a file and lightly sanded off the tires, give it some realism, you know. Now the chrome on the rally rims, we're gonna black out the holes, and we're also gonna, they were never chrome, the inserts were a silver, only the beauty rings were chrome. So we'll keep the brood, that's gonna be pretty tricky to do the detailing on this, but we'll try our and do our best job that we can. And as far as I can see, the center caps are more the Mexican hat style center caps on these Dodges. They had two or three different caps that they used on these, if I remember correctly. I don't know, remember, I'm old and haven't done real cars for like a lot of years, and these ones I see are Mexican hat, kind of very rounder. The late 70s ones had more, I don't know how to put it, but the 70s, late 70s center caps were more blocky or something, I don't know how to put it. And I won't even attempt to describe it. So, that's what we got. Oh, I put the shocks on. I first glued them into the wrong hole and then thinking they're too long. And, oh, you gotta cut them down, Chuck. But those other holes in there, that was for the exhaust. I'm like, duh. So, yeah, today we'll glue the engine in and front subframe because finally got some bench time and we'll do some of that stuff. And whether I come back and do that video or not, I'm not sure. I'll check the length of this video, my friends. Actually, you know what? No. We're just going to cut it out today as an update. Short and sweet, just like me. I'm short and sweet, even though sometimes she calls me an asshole, she doesn't call me sweet. Sweetheart. Anyways, my friends, enough blah blah blah. Thank you muchly for chucking us out today. I know what else I'm going to say. I've got some, shoutouts, is what you call it. I'm going to call it highlighting some other YouTubers and other model car builders in some I've wanted to do this for over a month now because some of your guys' work is fantastic. Maybe every video I'll show one or two cars that I think are pretty hot, pretty awesome, and I'm sure you guys will agree with me because you guys are awesome too. The work these guys do is mind-blowing. I'm not even in the same page of the telephone book as these guys. We don't have telephone books anymore, Chuck. We got Google. Yeah. Anyways, gonna go back to watching Elvis Presley and building, and I'll see you guys on the next week, probably Tuesday or Wednesday. Tuesday. I don't work till next Friday, so I got, 5 days off. Cheers. See you then with some other videos that you'll see. Wow, I'm so looking forward to it. Okay.